going to talk about the triple beam balance. Now, for our normal labs, we won't necessarily be using the triple beam, but it's kind of nice to see what scientists used to use, and some actually still do use it, and then to see where we've progressed from there. So this is a triple beam balance, and it's called a triple beam balance because if we zoom in here, it has three beams. One, two, three. The beam in the front measures in 1 gram increments. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. The middle beam measures in hundreds, and the last beam back here measures in tens. Before you use a triple beam balance, it's very important to make sure that all your writers are at zero, like they are here, and that your balance is zeroed. To make sure it's zeroed, the two lines should line up. The line on the beams should line up with the zero mark here. This one's a little bit off, but it should be okay. To zero the balance, there's a knob all the way over on this side that you can turn, and it'll zero the balance. So we'll turn it just a little bit, and let's check again. We'll make the adjustments. And our balance is now zeroed. Okay? What that means is that there's zero weight on the pan, or there's zero mass on the pan. And that's important. Because if you don't have it zeroed, then your measurement will not be accurate. Okay? So using this, let's see, what can we take the mass of? Let me pause right here and I'll get an object to take the mass of. All right, so we're gonna take the mass of my Yoda bobblehead doll, okay? Now we're gonna see how much mass he has. So we're gonna take him, we're gonna put him on the pan. Notice how the scale tips up. So now we have to move the writers in order for those two lines to meet back up again. We're going to start with our heaviest writer, which is the hundreds in the center. So you'll always start with the heavy one. And you'll move it. Now notice how it goes all the way down. That's too much weight, so we're going to move this back. Now we'll move the writer in the back until it drops down again. Okay, so we've moved it and it's dropped down. Again, this tells us that now the beams are too heavy. So we move this back to where it pops up again. Okay, now we go to our last beam. And we'll move this over slowly until our lines meet up. Okay. So if we take a look at our lines right now, it's still a little too heavy. So I'm going to move this writer back until that line comes back up. And it's in line with the zero. Are we there yet? Not quite. A little bit more. Now we are. Okay? Notice how they're lined up at zero. So if we take a look at our writers, we have 80 in the back. I know it's a little bit blurry, but trust me. 80. Then 2.5. So our Master Yoda here has a mass of 82.5 grams. And that's how you would use a triple beam balance. Okay? To reset it, we'll take Yoda off and we'll bring all our writers back to zero, and the scale is, or the balance is ready to be used again. Okay? And that, in a nutshell, is how you would use a triple beam balance.